director at China-Eurasia Council for Political and Strategic Research in Armenia. And being the director of China-Eurasia Council, Mher obviously wrote about China and China's relations with Iran. He especially focused on the negotiations of the JCPOA and the process that took place within the UN Security Council prior to the conclusion of the agreement. And he also talks a lot about China's Belt and Road Initiative and the role that Iran plays in it. Yeah, the floor is yours.
Thank you very much for introducing my chapter. And before my speech, I want to thank International Institute for Peace for inviting me and for their support. And special thanks go to Professor Heinz Gärtner and editorial board for their leadership on this work. And today I will speak about Sino-Iranian Uneasy cooperation after the signing of the GSPA in the era of the Belt and Road Initiative. In a broader sense, China is interested in dissolving the Iranian nuclear issue in a peaceful way and by preserving the stability of Iran for five main reasons. The first one, China is interested in Iran's energy sources. The second one, China is interested in Iran's stability because it is located in the center of important energy communications and transportation routes. The third one, China is interested in a strong and safe Iran as it reduces US influence in the Middle East. The fourth, Iran is an important market for Chinese products. And the next one, China sees Iran as an important player in the Middle East for its Belt and Road Initiative. In the United Nations Security Council, China tried to direct the increasing tensions on the Iranian nuclear program towards negotiations and to exclude sanctions on Iranian oil and gas production. As we know, after the long negotiations, the permanent 5 plus 1 and Iran finally agreed on GSPOA on July 14, 2015. On January 23, 2016, in Tehran, Chinese President Xi Jinping met with the Iranian President Hassan Rouhani. Previously, Chinese President had avoided traveling to Iran, likely due to the desire to avoid the perception of overly close relations with Tehran. Since visit reversed this trend, the visit also resulted in the establishment of a China-Iran comprehensive strategic partnership. Iran and China also signed a bilateral memorandum of understanding on joint promotion of the Belt and Road Initiative. Overall, the two states have set the ambition goal of increasing bilateral trade tenfold to $600 billion. China and Iran have reached a $10 billion deal to construct two nuclear plants in Iran and will cooperate in the design and modernization of Iran's heavy water reactor at Arak. The customs administration of the two countries reached an agreement on custom information sharing as part of a joint plan of action in customs cooperation. China offered Iran to become a member of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. In 2017, the bilateral trade volume exceeded $47 billion, with a year-on-year growth of 90%. The Norbazadegan and the Adivaran oil fields jointly developed by China and Iran with contract value of more than $5 billion. As part of Belt and Road Initiative, China CITIS Group in September 2017 announced that they would extend a $10 billion credit line for Iran to build everything from railways to hospitals. The Cherry MVM, with its market volume of nearly 300,000 vehicles per year, has become the third biggest automobile company in Iran after Saab and Fodro. China is also interested in making Iran one of the leading players in its Belt and Road Initiative, main direction, which is called Silk Road Economic Belt. On January 2017, a train having left the Ivu city in East China's Zhejiang province and moved from Kazakhstan and Turkmenistan arrived in Iran, having traveled a distance more than 10,000 kilometers. But the Sino-Iranian economic cooperation was threatened when the US withdrew from the JSPOA. And when Washington reimposed the unilateral sanctions on Iran that had been lifted or waived under the JSPOA. For these reasons, it is very hard for Chinese companies to make new investments and start new businesses in Iran. The sanctions imposed by the US on Iranian financial and economic sectors actually excluded Iran from international economic and financial systems. It is very hard for Iranian, Chinese and other foreign companies which work in Iran to get foreign currency through international bank transfers there. For this reason, many foreign companies, Chinese companies are leaving Iran. Chinese leading telecommunications equipment and consumer electronic manufacturer Huawei is also appeared under the heavy sanctions of the US. As a result, its CFO, Meng Wanzhou, was arrested in Canada as Washington accused her of helping Huawei dodge US sanctions on Iran. In sum, also there was some development in Sino-Iranian cooperation in the Belt and Road Initiative framework during the last years. It will now be very hard to imagine new Chinese investments in Iran. Furthermore, Iran will remain one of the main transit directions of Silk Road economic base China, Central Asia, Western Asia economic corridor, but because of US sanctions, the cooperation in other fields will stay limited. In conclusion, Chinese policy on Iran's nuclear issue is to maintain and implement a negotiated JCPOA for political and diplomatic efforts. Thus, even after May 8, 2018, when the US announced its withdrawal from the JCPOA, Chinese authorities announced that China would maintain communication with all parties and continue to protect and execute the agreement fully. In this new reality, Iran will try to find ways to develop economic cooperation with China in the framework of Belt and Road Initiative, but given the US sanctions, the process will be very hard and restricted. Now we can also witness Rouhani's Ahmadinejad moment, as during the presidency of Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, Rouhani frequently criticized Ahmadinejad's look to the East policy, mentioning that Iran must cooperate mostly with the West to solve the Iranian nuclear problem. But recently we see that after the US reimposed sanctions on Iran, Rouhani and his team have shown great disappointment with the West, and now they are trying to lead Iran to the Sino-Russian camp by creating a strategic partnership with Beijing and Moscow. Of course, efforts towards implementation of the instrument in support of trade exchanges, which are led by France, Germany and the UK, are a positive sign for the JCPOA, but cannot actually be helpful to Iran, as the mechanism is expected to cover non-sanctionable essential goods such as humanitarian, medical and farm products. It is not expected to address oil-related transactions, which are of vital importance for Iran. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you all discussants for your contributions. At this point, we're already very advanced in time. I would like also to turn to the audience, and I'm sure you have lots of questions. We will have